Is it possible to see something that isn't there? Before you answer, consider this simple-looking wand. Can you believe it's actually capable of displaying the time in midair? Watch. See the numbers? Yet? They're not really there. The Sterling family has been seeing things lately. They're not sure exactly how to describe it, but then again, how do you describe terror?
We loved this house the first time we laid eyes on it. It had everything. There was a great backyard for Billy, a new gourmet kitchen for my wife, Sally. You could almost taste the great meals that were going to come out of a kitchen like this one. Also separate maid's quarters for our trusted nanny, Maggie. We were lucky to have her. She and Billy had developed a very special bond.
I think it's time for bed, Billy.
We were sure that this would be our home for a long, long time. The trouble began one night when Billy woke up hungry and decided to raid the kitchen for cookies and milk. Went by without any other incidents, but Billy was still shaken by the red-eyed monster. He kept insisting that it was real no matter what we told him. I turned in early that night. Sally was still in the kitchen cleaning up.
Sure.
Disclosure on the house.
Yes.
I called the realtor first thing the next morning. Well, tell him. I finally got her to admit that there was something unusual associated with the house. The original owner hanged himself in the garage. There was no note.
Suicide.
No explanation. No one ever figured out why it happened. But the realtor insisted that there was never any paranormal activity reported.
No, I don't believe in those kind of things, but it's still something you need to know before you buy a house.
Okay. The first thing I want to say is this house is not haunted.
I agree with Mr. Sterling. Now, I know we're all a bit on edge, but there's got to be a logical explanation.
Was there a logical explanation for why the original owner committed suicide?
What does that mean? Suicide isn't always a logical act, Sam.
I know that, but I know what I saw, Don. Okay, maybe the house isn't haunted, but how do you explain what Billy and I both witnessed right here in this room?
Well, if you don't mind my saying so, I think we should all calm down.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
What are you doing?
Look over there.
Oh.
Okay. That's a possibility. But what made the lights suddenly go off? And Billy and I both heard that horrible breathing sound.
There was a short. I told you, I checked the circuit breaker. Maybe the breathing you heard was the heating fan kicking in.
I don't know, Don. It was so real and so frightening.
I think Mr. Sterling's right. Well, there's an explanation. But you know, we're overlooking the larger picture here. And that's Billy.
You're right, Maggie. Billy just hasn't been the same since he saw those eyes the other night. Those lights.
You're still very upset, aren't you, Billy?
Maggie. It was real scary.
Well, I'm sure it was, dear. But you know where all that comes from, don't you?
Right up here.
Oh, you have a wonderful imagination. That's the greatest gift a child can have.
But it made me feel so bad.
Well, sure, that's how it works. You know, sometimes we imagine things that make us happy. Sometimes we imagine things that make us afraid. And then as we grow older, we pay less and less attention to our imaginations, and we live very dull lives indeed. You won't let that happen, will you, boyo?
I won't.
Promise me?
Promise.
Love you, Billy.
Good night.
Good night, sweetheart.
Was there an evil presence at work here? If so, was it really the nanny? She didn't live in the house at the time of the other problems. Or perhaps the red-eyed specter was now protecting the Sterlings. No bad incidents had ever happened to them, not yet anyway. Is this story totally made up? Or is it glowing with truth?